Good morning, good evening, good night, wherever, however, and whenever you're listening. Welcome to another episode of The Melanin Report. I'm your host, Marquise Lupton, and we have another spectacular show for you today. It's Wednesday, so you know we have a great interview lined up. Today we have the founders and owners of the Melanated Bar, which is a black-owned family-operated skincare line based in Chicago, Illinois. And wait for it, who has also reached $1 million in sales. That's dope. So, the company is known for its top-quality, all-natural products, including the turmeric scrub, the glow kit, and the customizable build-your-own box model. That's what I'm interested in, to tell you the truth. And with a diverse range of products, the Melanated Bar has positioned itself as a go-to brand for those looking to experience the best in natural skincare. I cannot wait to get into the details with them and talk to them about their business. Also, if you haven't had the chance to listen to part one of this week's podcast with Dr. Kimiki Campbell discussing our top five headlines of the week, well then, ease on down that podcast road and do yourself a favor and check that out. Again, our guests today are Paula Delores and Chris Gibbs of the Melanated Bar. Welcome to the Melanin Report. How are you all doing today?
We are good. We are great. Excited to be here. Thank you for having us.
Thank you. Appreciate it. We are doing good this Wednesday morning.
Oh, all right. Well, let's jump right into it. First and foremost, congratulations on reaching $1 million in sales. So can you share the journey and the hard work that went into achieving this significant milestone?
Yeah, absolutely. So I actually founded the Melanated Bar in 2017. This was a time where I just had my second daughter and I really just wanted to make some changes in my life, you know, just healthy living, you know, just help really just, you know, do better for my children so that I can live longer for them and happier for them. And honestly, the easiest part to do that is with my skin. You know, it's hard to cut out food and say, oh, I can't have this in my food. But, you know, you can make that choice easily with your skincare by just, you know, choosing not to use it and opting for another product. And you ain't got to worry about the taste, you know, because healthy foods sometimes don't taste all the best with the skincare. You know, it's easy. I'm not tasting it. I'm just applying it. And so I just started mixing my own products up. And it just literally started to transform my skin after my child. I know other women can probably agree with this, is that your skin changes so much. My skin was very dry, it was blotchy, and I just was really, really feeling insecure about myself. So when I realized this, I just started mixing some skincare products, applying it, and it really just turned in a way to honor myself, because now I'm spending time on myself. I'm a lot happier, I look better, so I was feeling a lot better, and I just realized this was something that I had to start sharing with other women. And now we have products that are open for men and women, so I'm happy to start branching into that avenue too. We did just recently hit $1 million in sales. It was definitely hard work that took a lot of effort. I mean, a lot of trials, a lot of errors. You know, I ran a lot of Facebook ads. We did a lot of email marketing, as well as showing up to vendor shows, Essence Fest, Black Women Expo in Chicago. And then also we recently did one at Frizz Fest. So just showing up in front of our audience and just showing them like we actually care about you. We actually, you know, don't want to just push our products on you. Like, we want to teach you how to use these products, teach you how to take care of your skin and make sure like you're doing everything that you can do, you know, just to be a better version of yourself. So just having our customer and caring for them at the forefront of our mind, I realized was really the key to us achieving $1 million in sales.
Yeah. And you hit on it a little bit. I do want to go a little bit deeper here with this question. So what inspired you to start the Melanated Bar, and what sets your skincare line apart from the others in the market?
Yeah, absolutely. So I started it because I was tired of these skincare products pushing products on us that just were harmful, like with parabens, sulfates, just a whole bunch of ingredients that just really aren't needed in skincare products. They're just in there because they want to cut the quality so that they can sell more for less, basically. And a lot of those ingredients just have a high risk of leading to cancer. It could interrupt fertility. And that was just something that I was like, you know what? If I could cut out anything, I'm just going to cut out those things. The main thing that sets our skincare products apart is that we use natural ingredients, and then we don't have any harsh chemicals in our products. So there are a lot of Black women, for example, that deal with hyperpigmentation. There are some bleaching ingredients that a lot of Black women like to reach for because, you know, it works fast. It literally zaps the hyperpigmentation from your skin, but they don't think about the aftermath in it. After you use those ingredients, like, it literally just transforms your skin and makes it more thin, more delicate, more sensitive. And that was something that I just really couldn't stand seeing. So I decided to start using turmeric in my skincare products. Turmeric is just an all-natural ingredient. We all know it. We all love it. And it literally just brightens the skin. It helps fade dark spots naturally. And you don't have to worry about, you know, the skin lightening and everything like that, because that conversation is so controversial. So I just decided that is something that I'm going to 100% stay away from.
I love it. We are going to get into the ingredient discussion in a few here. But you did mention something that sparked a question in my mind. You talked about the marketing, the Facebook marketing and the emailing. So with you all gaining traction pretty quickly here, can you discuss the role of marketing and community engagement in your brand success?
Yeah, so right now, I think it's safe to say we are all dealing with inflation. Inflation is literally kicking everybody butt right now, including ours. And the biggest thing right now is that people, you know, they don't want to spend money. So right now we're actually pivoting our marketing from sale to educating. So, we're doing tutorials. We're sending out emails about how to do a skincare routine, how to stay on top in your skincare routine. And just doing that alone just shows people like, hey, this company just don't want my money. This company isn't just, you know, power hungry and, you know, just want to make a dollar off of me. I genuinely feel like this company, the Melanated Bar, cares about us. And just doing that alone, like, I receive a lot of comments and, you know, emails back just talking about like how grateful they are for, you know, coming across our company because we're just very authentic. And even with the Facebook marketing, right now we're just, you know, pushing out skincare tips. We're, you know, showing up where our customers are showing up. So they like to be on, you know, meme pages. They like to, you know, be on the shade room or whatnot. So we'll go in there and we'll comment and say, hey, you know, that's funny. You know, that happened to me too. Or, you know, even sometimes we disagree with them. So just showing them that we're human and we're not just like another company, I think really helps with our marketing at this time.
So it really sounds like you all are taking like a human grassroots approach with your marketing then.
Absolutely. We are, because we're so small, you know, in the scope of Dove and Neutrogena and Cetaphil and everything. I feel like showing them that we're human, showing them that we're just like them, and we're, you know, a growing Black skincare business right now. I feel like it really just makes them trust us more because it appeals to them. We get inboxes every day and they're like, hey, Paula. And they think they're talking to me, but they're really talking to my assistant. But it's the fact they're like, hey, Paula, that really just makes me happy because it doesn't have to be like a to whom it may concern or, you know, like, hey, you know, the Melanated Bar. It just comes off more authentic. It comes off like we're actually friends. And that's something that I do want to keep going even as we do grow.
Yeah. And talking about growth, do you see your products being on the shelves of Target, Walmart, any of your big box situations?
So I do want to mention the fact that she glanced over that email marketing, Facebook marketing, without mentioning that she learned that stuff from the ground up, right?
Wow. So
like, you know, now we've hired people to assist us. But when Paula started this in 2017, we didn't know much. Even though she has a business degree, I know a little business, but we didn't know much about Facebook ads or email marketing, text message marketing. But when I was working full time, she was literally at home taking courses and figuring those things out. And she was putting it into practice and it paid huge dividends. And so then when we talk about future products and stores, at the moment, we're turned off because we would have to do basically, you know, what some of those other companies do, right? We may have to water down some of our naturalness and our ingredients so that we stretch these products out, because we got to fill POs, right? If we want to go in Sally's or Target or whatever, we got to fill these 1,000 order POs, right? And the best way to stretch these out, plus have the lifeline on that ingredient, is to find some of those more harmful ingredients to mix in. So it's like right now, we would rather stay 100% owned by us and do things our way and keep it as natural as possible, you know, and then see, you know, maybe down the line, if, you know, we find somebody with the right supply chain, you know, we could talk about, you know, going at a distributor level, you know, into stores and whatnot.
And to add on is that right now, as mentioned, you know, we are still growing. Right now we're working on a lot of brand recognition, you know, brand awareness, trying to get our name out there. So even if we were to go into stores right now, we have to literally push all of our marketing to get people to those stores. Then now we're cutting our profit because they're not coming straight to us. You know, they're going there, or they're not even going there. So now we have products sitting on these shelves and they're not moving. And next thing you know, they're clearancing them out. And once they clearance them out, we don't make any money. We actually still have to pay for those products. And, you know, now it's just a sour taste on our in our mouth because, you know, our products flopped or whatever. So right now, I think building our brand awareness before we get into stores is our main goal. Because when we post it, when we say we in Target, Walmart, CVS, Walgreens, Sally's, any of these places, I want to just make one post and I want the Mella Babes to show up and show out. So
dig
I
it.
Need to just gain way more of them.
I will tell y'all this. You, the listener, I hope that you're picking up what they're putting down, because they are talking some serious business here. I love it. Sustainability, that's what we're basically talking about here. So sustainability and natural ingredients are important aspects of your brand. So can you discuss some more your commitment to eco-friendly and skin-friendly products?
Yeah, so right now, as already stated, you know, we use all natural ingredients, all clean ingredients in our products. That is something that we are going to stick with from now into the future. We are going to absolutely always avoid parabens, always not put any products in our products that are animal cruelty made. We make sure that that is in our mission statement because, you know, this is important to our consumers. You know, the earth is important to our consumers. But also to go on to sustainability, right now we are looking at ways where we could do refillable. So, you know, people could ship in their empties to us and, you know, we could send them a new set of products, you know, for a discount, or have drop off locations, you know, as we grow eventually. But we do have some products now that that you could reuse. So, for example, we have a facial application brush. This brush is made out of silicone. It's easy to clean. You could reuse it as many times as you want to. And this is something that the Mella Babes actually say that they appreciate, because they've been so used to just using, you know, plastic spatulas to get their products out. And then next thing you know, they're tossing it in the trash. So just doing little changes like that to start off until we make, you know, more revenue, more profit to be able to truly change the entire landscape of our business, I would believe is super important to us.
Oh, okay. So then how do you ensure the quality and effectiveness of your products, and what steps do you take to maintain that consistency then?
Absolutely. So starting off, I was making everything myself, like the
formulas. Man.
Yeah, I was like a chemist. You would think I had two or three. So I was mixing and batching and everything in my kitchen, making all of these products. But when we started really seeing sales come through, this is when I looked at my husband and he looked at me and we were like, maybe we should go ahead and get a chemist in here, you know, and start revamping the recipes, making them more shelf stable so that the lifetime expiration on them, you know, could be expanded. So we started outsourcing. We started working with cosmetic chemists that came in and just switched everything up for us. But also we send our products to labs. So we have our products shipped out and we send them to a lab. They test for, you know, bacteria, you know, anything harmful that could grow in the products, so that we can actually stand behind our products. Like, yeah, we may be, you know, an at-home based skincare business, but we're not a DIY skincare business. Like everything we do with safety and sanitation in the forefront of our mind. We just bought a house. I don't know how many 3,000 square. We just bought a 3,000 square foot house from the business. Like, the business literally just bought us our first home.
Wow, congratulations.
Thank you. We have an entire basement that we are setting up as our warehouse. So now, you know, we have the systems in place. You know, I could have people come in and help mix these products and everything as well. But yeah, everything we do, lab tested, and, you know, we ensure the safeness of it.
Serious business here. Like I was saying, you all brought a chemist in. The business has helped you purchase your first home. And there's this word that you kept on saying that really, really stood out. Melibays. So I'm assuming that these are your customers. I'm actually looking forward to my wife becoming a Melibay as well. So what customer feedback or testimonials has stood out to you as a testament to the impact of the Melanated Bar's products?
We get so many reviews. Some of the ones that do stick out the most to us are the ones where they literally tell us how much these skincare products have changed their lives. It's so many Black women out there, brown women, that just deal with skincare conditions that leave them feeling depressed, you know, stressed, anxious, you know, feeling less than, because they feel like when they go out the house, people are staring at them, or they don't look like the next girl, you know, that looks like that girl, basically. And it really gets down on you and on your spirit. So getting these emails and these reviews saying like how we saved, like they literally tell us like, you saved my life. And it's really mind blowing, because that's truly how they feel. But on the other hand, we have customers that went through chemo. We have customers, you know, actually battling cancer. And when you go through those things, it dries your skin out. It makes your skin thinner and more sensitive. And we've had numerous cancer patients and cancer survivors tell us like how these products literally soothed their skin and got it back to normal, and they couldn't use anything else on their skin but our products.
Wow.
So getting these testimonials and these reviews, they keep us going. They make me realize, you know, what I'm doing is actually, you know, right. Like, it's actually good. I'm actually making a change, because, you know, this is skincare.
Yeah.
People are putting this on their skin. And so I literally used to go through anxiety. I used to cry to my husband like, oh my God, like, you know, this person said they don't like the product. And, you know, I have to realize, you know, I'm no different from the big box companies that's in Target. You know, it's skincare. Everything doesn't work for everybody. But also the fact that people are trusting me to put these products on their skin keeps me going.
Yeah. The skin, I mean, the skin, it's the biggest organ that we have. So why not use products to take care of it? So let's now talk about your ingredients and your formulas and whatnot. So your background and experiences, how did that influence the selection of ingredients for your skincare line?
So the biggest thing that I thought about when I was starting this business was I didn't want to have too many different oils and products and ingredients for my products, mainly because I was a small business. I was growing. And, you know, I didn't want to have to buy a big, you know, 50-pound gallon drum of avocado oil and, let's say, orange oil or almond oil or, you know, any kind of oils. I wanted to keep it simple but keep it straightforward at the same time. So I made that executive decision then, you know, to use these same oils, you know, throughout the product. So right now we don't use any almond oils, no nut oils, no nut products, period, because people have nut allergies.
Yeah.
And that's something that, you know, I always want to just keep in mind when customers purchase these products, because they don't look at ingredients.
Yeah, you're right.
I've gotten multiple emails from customers saying, hey, I see this product I just got in the mail has avocado oil in it. I'm actually allergic. And just to think about, you know, say a customer had a nut allergy and I used nut oils in it or nut products and they didn't read it and now they're using it and boom, you know, now we got a bigger issue on our hand. So I studied, you know, the best ingredients. I bought books. I went to the library. I was on blogs. I was looking at like the makeup of different products. So I was looking at oils that, you know, didn't clog the pores, but it also was still very thick at the same time to make sure, you know, it helps with dry skin. And then I started looking at, you know, herbs and botanicals because I don't want to use artificial colors in my products because that just goes into the not natural route, which I wanted to stay away from. So I looked at turmeric. I looked at tomato powder. I looked at beet powder for some of the products as well. And so I just use everything that I could find on the earth in my products. Just to keep everything safe.
And you just brought up turmeric, and let's talk about that. The turmeric scrub and the glow kit. These are products that stood out to me. So can you describe the benefits and results that customers can expect from using them?
Absolutely. So some of the top skin conditions that Black people deal with is hyperpigmentation, eczema, inflammation, and acne and oily skin. Those are some of the top and some of the main skin conditions that we deal with. Turmeric is anti-inflammatory, so it's really good if you have eczema that's flaring up, psoriasis that's flaring up. You know, you could just apply that to your skin. And I mean, you may not see or feel a difference immediately, but you keep using it over a day or two, you know, you'll start to feel the difference in your skin. But turmeric for hyperpigmentation, instead of bleaching it, like I mentioned, you know, this just helps brighten the skin overall. So now you wake up and, you know, your skin is just dry or it looks dull and you just, you know, you're not feeling your best. You grab our turmeric face bar, you grab our turmeric scrub, you put it on, wash your face, boom, instant glow. Like, it's just a transformation that I think a lot of people want to see. So I do tell people, like, you know, after your first use, you would instantly see your skin brighter. Now, that's not to say, you know, that you're going to see like a miraculous result overnight, but you'll see the difference in it. But turmeric, it has just been so good to my skin and to my customer skin. If you go to my Instagram or website, like, you could just see so many different transformations from just this simple route. We actually just met a guy. We knew this guy from India for a while now.
Yes.
And my husband goes to his store. What do you call it? The corner stores or whatever. And you could tell him.
No, Indian guy. They have a couple corner stores out here in Chicago. And in India, he knows about our business and what we do.
Wow.
And so he's connected. You know, in India, they grow turmeric, right? It's really popular. Mm-hmm. Everybody's doing it. They use it on everything, right? And so immediately, you know, we connected. And now, you know, we're looking at trying to get even rawer turmeric right from India, or, you know, right from the source. Because, yep, you know, with inflation now, right?
Man.
The stuff that's here, it's the one up in price. And the quality, anytime price goes up, quality has to go down a little bit, right? Because you got to stretch it out. And so we're already planning for the future by saying, you know what, let's see if we can create this connection and get that supply chain I talked about, right? Coming right from India to us here in the United States. Mm-hmm. So that way we can get it right to the people who need it.
Oh, man. That's... y'all are playing chess. Y'all are playing 3D chess. I love it. And turmeric. For myself, just to tell a little quick story here, my oldest, when she was younger, she was sick for about 3 days straight. And my friend Charlene from Jamaica, she came in the house and was like, well, that's because you're giving her all of this medicine. What you need to do. And what she did was she boiled some milk. Put a dash or two of turmeric, stirred it up, and gave it to my daughter. In 6 hours, this kid was cured and jumping off the walls, like she wasn't sick for the last 72 hours. And I was just like, man, what is this? And that was the first time that I was introduced to turmeric.
Absolutely. And that's why that route is so important. It's so vital because, again, you know, like I mentioned, wanting to do better for my body and how you mentioned, you know, giving your daughter this medicine, you know, to help her get better. You know, that's how we in America were raised. You know, it was always, you know, push this stuff, you know, push medicine, push these chemicals to put on your skin to heal your problems instead of going down to the root of it all. So I really appreciate you sharing that story, because that just pushed me a lot more to stay true to natural ingredients.
Hey, yeah, yeah. And talking about your natural ingredients, your build your own box. That's kind of unique. So can you tell us what that entails?
We actually call that our Melabay box. And with that, you can customize your own skincare routine. I always tell people this is the best place to start if you're not consistent, you don't know what your skin needs, or you just don't really want a full skincare routine. You just know you need something for your skin. So we have three different cleansers you could choose from, which is our turmeric, our charcoal, and our rose. The turmeric, like I mentioned, is really good for brightening dark spots and hyperpigmentation. The charcoal bar is really good for oily skin, acne-prone skin, and hormonal acne. And then the rose face bar is really good for anti-aging. It's really good for redness and sensitive skin. Then you can move on to your toner. Your toners, you could choose from the WWD toner and then also the rose water. The WWD toner is actually called white willow bark. It is a natural salicylic acid ingredient. So we don't use salicylic acid in our products right now because I have not done enough research on it to really see, you know, the effects on skin. So I looked for the next best thing, and that's when I came across white willow bark. And I used to actually get the bark and boil it on the stove, and then I used to squeeze it out like with the cheesecloth to get all the goodness out of it, and then I mix it up, and that's how I created that toner. But that's just to go in how, like, I'm really that stronghold on using clean ingredients on our skin. And then lastly, we have the rosehip oil, which our Mella babes call face crack. And then we also have, yes, they literally call it face crack because it's just that good. Like, wow. I'm going to get into that. But the daily moisturizer is the other option for the moisturizer. So you pick a cleanser, toner, moisturizer, boom. And there go your Mella babe box. It is three products for $45. When I dropped it, I would think maybe like a year ago, it went crazy. It's still going crazy. And people really love it because they could just switch it up however they think they need to.
Oh, man. And my wife's birthday is next month. I'm about to get all the husband points getting a couple of your boxes. I cannot wait. I'm going to get all the love. Thank you. Melanated Bar, for the love that I'm going to receive from my wife. We have about five minutes left here. So I want to talk about your proudest moments and achievements and your future moving forward. So first, can you share some of the proudest moments or achievements that the Melanated Bar has celebrated thus far?
So I think for me, because I was just watching her when she first started this. So I think one of the proudest moment for me is when she hired me basically to help her, right?
Wow.
And we didn't know that time until I looked up and she actually needed the help, right? I was going and I'd come in and, you know, there'd be orders and boxes need made. I'd started making a few boxes and then all of a sudden I was basically processing all her orders because she needed to do everything else. Mm. So that was like proudest moment for me. And for his achievement, it would definitely be hitting that $1 million. We wouldn't have hit the $1 million, I think, without going to the vendor show. So I put that in there. I think getting in front of our audience and being, you know, and having a visual along with the name behind the face behind the brand has been great for us. So I want to, that's probably our biggest achievement and then my biggest moment.
Yeah. And to add, the $1 million is one of our proudest moments, like he mentioned, but I would say it's the proudest moment because I didn't do it with investors. Mm. I didn't do it with your house. I didn't do it with, you know, any, you know, outside help outside of family. We did have one assistant that came in and made products or shipped orders, but just to know, like, we were in house and we hit $1 million in sales is just mind blowing. And it just truly shows, you know, you don't need a whole lot to make something out of nothing. And that's something that we are just going to keep doing. We're going to keep our overhead costs down and we're going to try to hit our next $2 million by the end of next year.
Man, I will tell y'all this. Y'all are the new American dream. Like put y'all on a poster.
I receive it.
I'm serious. Put y'all on a poster and send that around. This story, this interview has been absolutely amazing. So final question here. How do you envision the future of the Melanated Bar, both in terms of product offerings and impact within the skincare industry?
So as for product offerings right now, I think we could both agree that our next biggest investment is going to be SPF. SPF is something that our customers are always asking for, and I always have to outsource it, which I don't mind. But if I want to keep my customer, you know, at the Melanated Bar, then that's something that I need to start offering. That way I can educate my customers on the importance of using sunblock, because to be honest, a lot of Black people truly believe that Black people don't need sunscreen.
Yeah, they do.
And it's a toxic way of thinking, and it causes so much harm every time you step out the house and you're not protecting your skin. And this sun is not the same sun that it was 20 years ago. Like, this
you're
sun
right.
is something else. Yes. And if you don't put on your sunscreen, your black is going to crack. Black will crack, especially if you're not using SPF. So we are looking to expand into the SPF industry. Right now, we are looking for any help. So if anybody's listening to this that has any advice on getting into the SPF product line or could point us in the right direction, you know, you could reach us at Paula or Chris at themelanatedbar.com. And then we are looking to expand into body products by the end of this year as well. So body washes, body lotions and different things like that. And then... You
want to
add anything?
So before you were to see us in the stores, you probably see our products in like your hotels and different places that you know that we as consumers go out. You know, you would see
Airbnb
hands, soap, face wash, and soaps and stuff like that. You'd see us there in those offerings so that we can still be direct, you know, be consumer, and we'll go from there. And that, I think that's our biggest thing going into the future right now. How to make it, you know, every day to work. Were available.
And that'll help spread brand awareness, because now you're in their Airbnb or your hotel, you're washing your hands on this product, and you're like, wait, and then you go to the store, you're like, I was using this last week and I loved it. So now you're picking it up. So, you know, just spreading brand awareness right now, screaming our name from the mountaintop, running ads, sending out emails, and staying in front of our target audience is something that we are going to go hard for in the next coming years.
Chess. Like I said, chess. Playing chess. That is wow. When y'all said that you put your products in Airbnb, I wish that y'all would have saw my face, because my mouth just dropped. Because so this might be the most important question of our interview, and then I'm going to put a pin in it after that. So how can folks contact you? How can they order the products, your website, your social media handles? Have at it.
Yes. So if you are interested in shopping our products, you need help with your skincare routine, or you just want to chat in general, you could find us at themelanatedbar.com. And all of our social media handles are literally The Melanated Bar across all platforms, Lemonade, Twitter, X, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok. You can reach me directly at Paula at The Melanated Bar. And then you can reach my husband at Chris at The Melanated Bar as well. That's The T-H-E Melanated M-E-L-A-N-A-T-E-D bar.com.
Oh, man. The Melanated Bar on the Melanin Report. Oh, man. All this melanin. Love it. Paula and Chris, thanks again. This has been spectacular. I really appreciated this conversation.
Absolutely. Thank you for having us. I appreciate you sharing your platform, spreading our mission, and helping us reach our goal of more brand awareness. I truly appreciate it, and thank you for having us.
Oh, yes, of course, of course. And for you, the listener, the conversation continues on Friday with part three of this week's series. And as you know, we have our monologue and our panel of experts who will be joining us for part three this week. In the words of Run DMC, when you doubt your power, you give power to doubt. I'm Marquise Lupton telling you to trust your dopeness. Now enjoy these sounds and we'll see you on the other side. This is The Melanin Report.
You've been looking for.